Hi, my name is Ilana Boldvinnik, co-founder and a member of Tres. This has been going on since 2009.
Hi, I'm Rodrigo Viñas and I'm co-founder of Tres. We are an art collective. We do a lot of interdisciplinary work. Lately, we were just working a lot with photography.
We are a collective that researches waste, garbage, trash, and all related subjects. And of particular interest is the way waste is a social portrait of who we are and how we act in the world. Ubiquitous Trash is our latest ongoing series that started with a commission of the WMA. A thing that obsessed us a lot, this started in Hong Kong, being Hong Kong the fourth biggest port in the world. We were really concerned about the way trash travels around the world, not only as a merchandise, but also as trash itself.
We were just thinking about the movement of the trash around the world, like in the sea specifically.
So we consider ourselves scavengers of some sort. So we love walking around, picking things up, and trying to figure out what the story behind each of the pieces of garbage we find tells. One of the things that perhaps is amazing and that caught our attention is the constraints, the contrast between the constraints we have as humans to travel around the world every time migration is becoming a more difficult subject. And on the other hand, trash flows freely through the oceans and goes from one place to the other. So we found a lot of trash from very many different places in Hong Kong, and we started trying to trace the production, distribution, and so on of the trash. Photography is a way to inform ourselves about these objects. The lens works a bit as a way to contextualize whatever we find, but it also helps to go deep into the tiny little pores of everything that's happening in the material we find. So it's a way of informing ourselves, as we also sometimes use other methods. But photography has become important in that way. Also because you can play a lot with scale and perspective, and then you can actually place these strange objects in a different scale, and it conveys a totally different meaning. So we play a lot with macro and micro, and how this tension develops between both of them.